Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijja, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Today I went to local church, which was Carey Baptist Church. And over there, the person giving sermon, it was on redemption, that if you have a slave which have been kept with you for 100 denarii, and if somebody pays that money to the master of the slave, then slave has been redeemed from the slavery and he has been set free. A very good sermon, but he was talking about sins and all that, you know, as it in churches they do not understand that in Christ Jesus we have nothing to do with sin. We have been set free of the temple priest and their moral laws, written moral laws. We go by spirit, as the Samaritan and the Gentile did, and they enjoyed the freedom and salvation. Christ Philip stated in his gospel, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die, because they go by the spirit and by, not by the written moral laws of Moses or this one and that one. As the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, he did not go by any law. As the Pharisee and Sadducee who passed by, when they passed by, they say, hey, this is not, we know the man, or before we pick him up, we need a witness, this and that. He just picked him up and looked after him and saved his life. That is called philanthropy, which is the light of our Father. Only those possess who are living in spirit, not the dead in letters, as that temple priest and Pharisee and Sadducee were. So here I'm going to give you some videos on how our anointed elder brother redeemed us from the yoke of the temple priest, and at what price. So tonight, how our anointed elder brother redeemed us from the slavery of the temple priests and turned us into the very royal priest, independent royal priest. Tonight I went to the local Carey Baptist Church and listened to a sermon on redemption, in which Christ Jesus paid the cost of redemption by becoming the sacrificial lamb of God to set us free of the brick-built temple priests of Moses. You know, the temple priests, they sit in the brick-built made by human hand, the synagogue. They sit there and then they go on these laws, moral laws of Moses, and if you transgress against the moral law, they say, hey, you have committed a sin. You know, these moral laws are man-made. Such are the moral laws that if a Jew, he shakes hand with a Gentile or rubs shoulder with a Gentile, then the rabbi will say, hey, you have committed a sin. And that mean that they have made the Jews that far superior to the Gentile. They have pumped up ego in their head, and that's why you see them stiff-necked, you know. That whenever you want to talk to them, they think the Gentile, they are stupid people and they know all the knowledge. They are men of God. So that is how the rabbis boosted their ego. That is called killing. That's why John the Baptist told those temple priests, brood of vipers. In Jesus, you have to be humble And you should know that nobody is Jew or Gentile in God. When you are born, it is not you took the birth, God gave you the birth. In a country, whether it is dominated by white people, brown or black. In Jesus, we are all brethren. So, no more that rubbing the shoulder and other thing, you commit sin, no more sins, but hypocrisy counts. So these temple priests, they were dominating the simpletons, once born people, the children, babies, under the pretext of sin, and they put on a very, very heavy yoke that they themselves could not lift. So that's why Jesus said, you know, they will make you slaves to the sins, and under the sin, they are the people who administer them. So they will put a very heavy yoke on you and then milk you. So in Jesus, we do not worship God in the brick-built temples made by human hands, the synagogues, you know, where the temple priests dominate over people in the name of sins, but in the very temple of God that is not built by human hands, but by nature. This temple of God is known to many, you know, that this physical body is the temple of God. So in the temple of God, we worship our Father in truth and spirit. No more under the moral laws, scripture, that is milk for the once born babies that leads to works. So no more ritual or fasting or anything, you know. In Jesus, in the temple of God, we worship God, our Father, in truth. That means you should be truthful and in spirit, that you see that if somebody needs help, you help him. You don't just stand by. But law doesn't permit you to do this and that. As the Samaritan man is a good example. By the grace of our Father, we know him through his word, that our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus, came to deliver to us, that we must plant that his word, we must plant in our hearts before we can preach gospel with authority, which is called drinking the blood of Christ. Now, I have written on my t-shirt, no Christ in heart, no gospel but dead letters. So this sample of t-shirts are available on my channel and you can get them printed. These are the, you know, fishermen take nets to fish, to fish, and this is our nets. We put it on, and those who are seeking gospel, they will knock on your shoulder to ask your brother, explain me more, please. Then you do it. We don't throw pearls before swines. The people who are seeking gospel, they are very, very few. In Reading, I have been putting this shirt over 2-3 months, almost getting a year now by the other thing. And hardly anyone, you know, has come forward to ask, brother, what is this? They are, you know, so reserved. A nation of shopkeepers, they cannot offend anyone. So this gospel is offensive to the Antichrist. So they don't want to annoy anyone. Even the Antichrist, they do not want to annoy. So how can they preach gospel? No way. To preach gospel, you need to be courageous. You should be solitary, pleasing our Father, not pleasing the public. As the word came from the mouth of Jesus, Christ Philip, you know, said, in the beginning was the Word, and Word became flesh. He said, the Word cannot speak of its own. It needs flesh so that it can speak to us. And that flesh, name of the flesh was Jesus. So when it is the flesh that speaks, not the soul. So understanding his word, our gospel buried under the parables is called eating the flesh of Jesus to be, in order to be like him, to preach gospel to others. You can only preach gospel to others when you yourself have understood it. If you yourself in the darkness, then you can't show light to the others. So these dog-collared people, you know, they are themselves are hireling. They are anti-Christ. How can they show you the way to God? No way. So you have to be royal priest. Royal priests are solitary. They do not seek the praises of men, but their praises lie with our Father, who has ordained us into his service. Our master are the one who, to whom we are owing this debt of giving us the grace is our Father God. So we are to please our Father and not please the public. They don't owe us anything. We are solitary. They have to give their own account to God. We have to give our own account to God. That is why his word is called a double-edged sword, because when you preach gospel to others, you show them the way, then they also earn the rest and you earn the rest, in which you earn your rest and show others how to earn their rest. In Jesus, we do not lead anyone, as everyone is to give his own account to God, but we show them the way to rest, and the rest depends upon the person himself. So in Jesus, we do not enforce our will. We are free. Why should we make other people slaves? We, in by his word, or show them the way, that this is the way to freedom. And it's up to them. You take the animal to the water, but you can't make him to drink, you know. It's up to the animal to drink or not to drink. So that is what we do. We preach gospel. Those who are longing, seeking, they pick up the gospel. Those who are not longing, they say, oh, this is nothing, you know, he has no interest in it. And that's why Christ Thomas said, gospel is not for everyone. One in 1,000 and two in 10,000. So you should not be worried if people reject you. In India, the gospel is one in a million. Never mind 1,000, million, you know. Because over there, when people preach gospel, they always think, what will I get? What material gain I will gain by preaching gospel? No material gain, no preaching. Simple. So very few people over there are interested in gospel. And that is called freedom in God. When we don't impose our views on others, we are calling this, it's called freedom in God. As Pope, you know, he imposed his view. If you do not obey his will, he will cut your throat or burn you at stake. As the Mohammedan were doing, if you don't become the Mohammedan, and they will cut your throat and that is they call Islam. That is not Islam. In Jesus, you are no more slaves to the sins that were administered by the rabbis. So the rabbis were the judges whether you have committed sin or not. So the rabbis, their rabbis were ruling over the people like super ruler. People feared of the rabbi more than the king. Even today, you know, some of the Jews, they are told not to work on Sabbath. And even doctor, you know, medical doctor, you know, so educated, they will sit at home. Our rabbi said, don't work. So we are not working. And they, if a guest come, then they ask the neighbor, please, my guest will come. Can you make a cup of tea for them? And I'm not supposed to work because of the Sabbath. What a stupid people they are. So such are the stupid disciples of the rabbi. Disciples are those who do what their rabbi tells them to do. In Hinduism, is same thing as Judaism. In Hinduism, one of our Christ, you know, Namdev, he said, Hindu Anna, Hindu is blind. Turku, the one who is twice born, is clever. And one who is seed to serve God is wiser than the both. That is, Hindu Anna Turku Kana, Gyani, the knowledgeable, is wiser than Gyani Duha Tisyana, is wiser than both of them. So in Jesus we are laborers and workers, no more disciples. If you are disciple, then you will be under the domination of the rabbi or the dog called priest or the pope, then you are a disciple. But if you are independent and solitary, then you are a laborer walking on the entered into the narrow gate and walking on the narrow road that leads to salvation. So you have to be solitary yourself and make other people solitary. That is the double-edged sword we call His Word. In Jesus, you are no more slaves to the sins that were administered by the rabbis, who themselves were freemen through Oral Torah. Rabbis, you know, because they had the knowledge of the Oral Torah, which is His Word, but they became corrupt and started to love Mammon over God. Then they started to ply dead letters in their profession of Cohen. Cohen is a profession, not a tribe, for money than God. Brahman is also a profession. Brahman and Cohen, they are the same. All right, then the tribal people in the Middle East are a Levi tribe, people who do the job of Cohen. In India, we have quite a few tribes which are doing the job of a Brahman. Sarsut, Mohyal, and God, and other people, you know, quite a few to mention. So, in the next video, I will explain the rest. So, the Oral Torahs, His Word, sets you free. So, in Jesus, we are royal priest. We have the knowledge of His Word. So, that is why they work for Adam and we work for God. So that's why Jesus said that John the Baptist, who was working for Adam, who was an ideal rabbi, who were teaching the moral laws, and that's why he quoted that it's not good for Herod to marry the Philip's wife under the moral laws. But Jesus had nothing to do with the moral laws. He was of the God. In God, moral laws carry no weight than the righteousness or the cleanliness of the heart. So, That's why Jesus said, the least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist. And John the Baptist, as you know, was a great prophet Elijah. So we are in Jesus greater than prophet Elijah. And Christ Thomas said, we are occupying a field that does not belong to us. Field is this word, you know, preaching gospel and doing the duties for God, which is not our field, you know. That is used to be the field of the Levite tribe people, Cohen. And then he said, you know, when these people who ask to whom this field belonged, when they will ask us, give us our field, and we will give it to them with pleasure. So this is the situation. We are now occupying this field. We used to be these temple priest. So we are royal priest, greater than those temple priests. Our Father, God, bless you.